What's going on, everybody? You can call me Heroes3 Guy, and in this video, I'm going to be promoting a map. And this map was actually made by someone that I know personally. So for those of you that aren't familiar with me or my channel, which I've only had my channel for about a month and a half now, I've played a Heroes 3 since it came out. And in fact, I started playing Heroes of Might and Magic 2. That was my first experience to the Might and Magic series. I was in like kindergarten or first grade, but in second grade, Heroes 3 came out, got it right away, and I've been playing it ever since. And all the time that I've been playing Heroes 3, my two older brothers have also played Heroes 3, and they've played it consistently just as long as I have. And in fact, this map was made by one of my older brothers. So he's put a ton of effort to this map. I mean, a ton. A lot of attention to detail. I've ran a number of test runs on various parts of the map for him to give him some feedback. And finally today, just today, March 6th, 2023, this map was posted on mapsforheroes.com. So I deleted the old version of this map that I had been helping my brother test run. And I went to mapsforheroes.com and I downloaded the official finalized version. It's a huge map. As you can see, five players, and you have to play as Red. And there is an underground as well. So a pretty large size map. And of course, the name, as you can see at the top here, is Kingdom Siege, The Reckoning. And I'll read the description for you guys. The enemy has grown very strong. They want your land, your resources, and your artifacts. Protect your kingdom and destroy your enemies. And if you look here, some notes about the map. There's no dimension door. There's no fly, there's no water walk. There is town portal and resurrection, but they are restricted. So take that as you will. It tells you not to start as Rampart, but any other faction works. It's not for beginners, and that's very true. If you're a beginner, this map will be difficult. And good luck and enjoy. And of course, creator, my brother's little secret name there, Wingman27. And as far as this map, if I had to, you know, give you a little bit of a hint of what it's about, it's Heroes 3 on steroids across the board. I mean, you're going to have the best heroes in the game, with the best specialties, with the best creatures, with a crazy amount of them, the best artifacts, you know, eventually capped out primary stats. I mean, it is just Heroes 3 to the max, pedal to the metal. It's really cool. It's extreme. So I am going to press begin here in a minute and show you guys just the first turn or so. It does kind of have a unique starting setup, and I'll show you guys what I mean. But for those of you that would like to try out this map and maybe don't want to have any spoilers, maybe don't watch much longer so you don't see that. However, it would be great if you guys tested out this map. Let me know if you play it, what you think in the comment section below. We'd love the feedback. Or you could even just leave your reviews on mapsforheroes.com. I mean, it's been up not even a day, and I think it has over 70 downloads already, so that's pretty cool. It'd be really cool if you guys tried this map out and let us know what you think. So I'll go ahead and press begin, and let's go ahead and check this bad boy out. All right, so you get this message off the bat. Before you begin, I'd like to inform you that there are hidden treasures that have been placed in obscure locations around your kingdom. They could be in a path unlikely to be traveled, or tucked away in crevices and corners. They could come in handy. Good luck. And then it also informs you there are no treasures in the water or underground, so you may not want to spend your time moving heroes into crevices and corners in those areas. So we'll go ahead and press OK. And I'm not going to do anything with this guy. So as you can see, you're red. You start up in this northwest corner. But the things I wanted to show you, the kind of unique starting setup, is that you have these two heroes here who you essentially have to free. And if you look, I mean, Corgis is already level 27. He's got some nice secondary skills. You have Sir Mulich here, also some nice secondary skills. He's only level 3, but essentially you have to free these guys, and it's kind of a puzzle, if you will. And once you break through and you free them, you eventually will be able to send them through a portal to where you'll be able to actually use them in the game. And there may or may not be some prizes, if you will, once you break through all these monsters and then finally are released to be used in the game. So I'll show you guys what I mean. There's a lot of monsters, I won't say how many, that they have to break through. So let's go ahead and just start with Corgis here. He has a ton of spells, and if you look, he starts with just 8 Nyx Warriors. And you have to take out 20 to 49 Green Dragons. And if you look here, 20 to 49 Titans. So it's like, ooh, you gotta be quite a tactician here. We're not gonna retreat. And let's go ahead and check this bad boy out. And now I've test ran this for my brother, and you have a ton of spells at your disposal. You don't have Resurrection. There are a few key ones that would be really convenient, but they've been intentionally removed from the spellbook. And a number of methods you can do. I've done it a couple different ways, but we're going to go ahead. We're going to do the good old Berserk here. We'll Berserk these guys at a little closer. And we're going to move them up to a corner here so that instead of 3 dragons having their way on them at once, only 2 are going to be able to hit them at a time. Nope. A little morale there. That's not great. Oh, man, a lot of morale. All right. So he's backing up, hoping that I can come forward or around. If I move here and attack that guy, the third dragon will be able to come and hit me. So what I'm going to just go ahead and do is I'm going to get my spell off, and let's attack another 5-on-5. And, yep, we'll kill one. Let's go ahead and wipe one down. And let's let them work each other over. Alright, and then we're going to do some more Berserk here. We'll do the 5 and 3. No, because it'll hit me there. So 5 and 3 right here. And, we'll go ahead and just defend, let all these guys do their action. That way I don't kill this guy and then invite a strong stack, you know, 5 green dragons to come up and hit me. So we're going to buy ourselves a little more turns. Yep, we'll let that happen. I guess the stack's going to come up anyways. All right, so now we're going to get our berserk going again. 3 and 1. No, let's do 3 and 3. Boom. And yeah, let's go ahead and take one down. And then let's get our spells going again. We'll do 2 and 2, try to keep them even. And I'm down to 5. Possibly kill 1 to 2, yes, just take them. That worked, 1 stack came up and hit me. All right, and then let's go ahead and throw a little berserk on those guys. Let's hit them. Those guys are just sitting there hoping I'll take the bait, which I'm clearly not. And what I could do, I could cast some other spells, but, you know, a lot of things you could do. Counter-Strike, you could do Clone, you could do, you could repeatedly cure them. You get them buff enough, shield, maybe Stone Skin, some other things. I've played this an instance where I can just repeatedly cure my guy, and I'm curing more than the damage they're doing. A lot of little things you can do to pull off these battles that are seemingly impossible. And now Berserk's not going to do much here. So, you know, we could do Cure. We could do Shield. We'll go ahead and do that. We'll go ahead and just wipe one of them out. And then we can go ahead and let's see what we want to do here. Counter-Strike's not going to do anything for us. We can Bless. Let's see what his hit points are at. 55. Yeah, we can go ahead and Cure. Let's go ahead and kill one. Alright, and see, look, he's not gonna finish one off. We'll just cure him. Boom, boom. And let's go ahead and cure him again. Healing some spell or hit points. And, yep, go ahead and kaboom. There we go. So we did lose 6 of our 8, but we'll just go ahead and continue on. You look here, we move a little bit. Boom. All of our spell points are gone. We got a little bit of gifts, though, if you will, and then we're reinforced with a set amount of Nyx Warriors. Now we're back up to 7. So, of course, the less you lose in each battle, the better going forward. But we get a little bit of reinforcements. But now, we're obviously not going to be able to kill these Titans without our spell points. So if you look here, we're getting a total of 4 per day. So you're pretty much forced right now to just wait with Corgis. You have to wait until you feel you have enough spell points to cast the spells you need to win this next battle. And it goes on. You move forward, there'll be another event that'll drain all your spell points. Maybe there'll be some reinforcements or some gifts, you'll see, and so on and so forth. And the same is here for Sir Mulich. So we'll go ahead and move him through his little maze. We're just going to do the first battle here versus the peasants. Of course, we only have one sharpshooter. So you look, ooh, retreat. No, we're going to give it a shot. Ah. All right, so we're going to go ahead. We have tactics. Might as well put them up in a corner. Start combat. Shoot the closest stack. And let's go ahead, and if you look here, he actually does not start with any spells. So you have to get a little creative here. And essentially, this first tactic is you just kite the peasants. You know, you move far away, you shoot them, they get close, you move again, shoot them. But the tactics, each round, each creature, they evolve. And I'll explain a little bit more. And of course, with Corgis and your Nyx Warriors, it really depends on who you're going against, who your opponent is, for what spells you're going to use. So if you look here, they can't really reach there. So let's just go ahead and send them here. Hopefully that guy doesn't get morale. And let these guys come up here. Then we're going to move them again in the corner. All right. And then let's go ahead and get some damage in. And let's go ahead and send them over here. And, ooh, I like that. Let's grab them. And looks like we can hit this stack here. Now, the real threatening stack, I don't think is going to reach me next turn. So, you know, let's just hit him. May take a hit, but we'll retaliate, kill one, then move away. So now we'll send him up here. And, of course, it helps that you have Sir Mulich. You know, he gives +2 speed to all your units. Just an incredible specialty that just has its uses beginning to end. It's just powerful beginning to end. It's really nice. So another incentive to free this guy. Oh yeah, here we go. That's how one sharpshooter rules the peasants of the land. All right, boom, there we go. And then if you look, you know, he doesn't start with any spells. You send him here, get some goodies. You send him around the corner. It's gonna take away some spell points and you learn a spell. And you also gain one more sharpshooter. So you can split these into two stacks, keep them in one. And essentially, in order to beat these guys, you're going to need to incorporate that spell, Haste. And then again, once you finally beat Walking Dead, there'll be another event around this corner where you'll drain more spell points. So it forces you to wait. You can't just mow through. You're reliant on casting spells. So it takes time. You can't release these guys super early in the game. But of course, you beat these guys, you're around the corner here. And another little spoiler, if you plan on beating Beholders, they shoot, you're going to learn Forgetfulness. And you'll actually have to incorporate both Forgetfulness and Haste properly in order to beat these guys. And then you're going to round through here, drain spell points, you'll get another spell, which will be necessary to take on the next guys. And so on and so forth. And again, once you finally release these guys, they have great special abilities. There may or may not be some prizes for releasing them. And it's really neat. It's really cool. So that's kind of the starting situation. I won't go into it anymore. I will at some point in time do a playthrough on this map. And if you guys want to play this, that'd be awesome. And if you're having some trouble, you know, figuring out what the best tactics are for getting through this maze with these beginning heroes, perhaps I'll make a video showing how exactly you make it through, because it's not exactly easy. But yeah, it'd be great if you guys check this out. Again, this was made by my brother, who's also an amazing Heroes 3 player. He's played this game as long as I have. Really good, and he put a lot of effort into this map. Really cool if you guys check it out. Kingdom Siege, The Reckoning. It is on mapsforheroes.com, a large map with an underground. And yeah, so hopefully you guys check it out. If you like this video, give it a like. Comment for me, let me know what you think. And if you don't mind, please subscribe to my channel. And until next time, guys, take care.